time for our co-main event of the evening. And I have been so intrigued by this fight since it was first put together. The man you see walking through the cage right now, Terry Lemaire, good time they call him, currently making his Fight Atlantic debut while ranked number 8 among all Canadian bantamweights according to Tapology.com. And it's worthwhile. This man is incredibly talented. Of his 5 victories, 3 submissions, all of them by guillotine choke. But here's what's interesting, Chris. Started out his career 0-2. Took 3.5 years away to kind of right some wrongs. Went on this 5-fight win streak. Looked like, okay, man, he's rising up the ranks. Everything's going good. And then in his last fight out, he went down to the States and suffered a really bad knockout loss there. He's taking some time off. He tried to fight in between. He's had some fight cancellations. Probably not a bad thing necessarily when you suffer a bad knockout to take some time off. But I'm just so curious because highly respected, highly ranked, but coming off a knockout loss, does that impact his mindset? Does it make him gun-shy whatsoever against a very experienced opponent? I'm intrigued by what Terry Lemaire does in there tonight.
Yeah, and I guess time will tell. You never really know the psyche of a fighter and what's going to affect him, what's not. I mean, just watching the way he fights and his personality and how he carries himself, I think he's going to go in there guns a-blazing and it's not going to affect him. You take an opportunity to fly, you know, halfway across the country to be here and to take the opportunity against a guy with equal or more experience. You know, that shows that you're a gamer and that you're wanting to get in there, mix it up, and prove who you are or who you believe you are.
That's right. Big opportunity for Terry Lemaire. Meanwhile, on the other side of the cage is Rhino, Morgan Rhines. 1-0 under the Fight League Atlantic banner, scored a decision win over Eric Wilson at FLA 3 right here in the Moncton Coliseum. Fought most recently in December. He did suffer a decision loss there, but it was to a really respected prospect, Tishay Guthrow, somebody who I had actually seen compete in CFSC and can vouch for as a very, very talented prospect. 3 knockouts to his credit. Recently, though, received his BJJ purple belt. Like, he's working on the grappling side of things. That had been an issue for him in a couple of his losses, and so he's trying to tighten those things up. So, you know, somebody that's coming off a knockout loss, Morgan Rhines brings some power to the cage, but he's also trying to, you know, tie up the grappling and shore that up a little bit as well.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, when you get to this level, you really can't have holes in your game that are that drastic. You know, if you rely on being a striker and your ground game isn't that much of a deficit, somebody is going to come in and show you how to compensate for that. So, you know, kudos to him for stepping it up and really working on that game. And, you know, sometimes you can level up in time to take a fight like this and prove who you are. So we'll see. I feel like this is going to be a fight of styles and who brings what to the table. Morgan clearly his comfort is in his striking. And Lemaire likes to strike, but again, like you mentioned, has submission wins as well. So let's see what happens.
This is the co-main event of Fight League Atlantic 8. It is a professional bout, contracted a weight of 135 pounds and brought to you by East Coast Financing. Introducing first, in the red corner, representing Total Martial Arts Center in Timmins, Ontario, he has a record of 5 wins, 3 losses, Terry Lemaire! And standing across the Fight League Atlantic cage from him, in the blue corner, representing Wolf Run Martial Arts in Charlottetown, Prince Edward Island, he has a record of 5 wins, 6 losses, Morgan Rhines! When the cage door closes, referee Ryan Potter is in charge of the action.
Co-main event here at Fight League Atlantic 8. Morgan Rhines in the black, Terry Lemaire in the white. Touch of gloves gets the action underway. Two veterans looking to make a statement here.
I was just going to say, watch for Morgan to throw heavy rear kicks. He loves that kick. It is, you know, one of his staples. And I would advise it to throw it in this situation.
Of course, following the theme of the night here with Orthodox versus Southpaw.
Yeah, once again. Ooh, little slip there.
Oh, slapping kick there.
love when you kick an elbow. Ooh, nice check there.
Both men aggressive with the kicks, but studying early, not overcommitting to anything right now. Chopping the legs a bit, working the body.
Yeah, when they throw, they're throwing heavy, but they're taking their time here, measuring distance, using some feints. More so Terry Lemaire is using a little more feints, a little more movement. Morgan is kind of zoned in, just looking to explode here. Love to see the progression through the night when we have fights that you go from amateur, you go to the advanced rules, you go to the pro rules, and see. Nice catch and toss to the ground by Lemaire.
Nice
when you get
work.
To see the athletes perform at different levels and different stages in their career, it's just nice to see.
Absolutely. You can see, again, these two veterans have been in there. They've got some experience between them. You can see it in there. Yes! Throwing everything at full power early. Lemaire continues to flash out that high kick, which makes sense. You know, he's investing in the low kicks and then dropping up there. And meanwhile, Ryan's landed that nice right hand in that exchange.
Yeah, nice little hook over the top. I think that kind of stung Lemaire. You see he smiled there at him.
Which always means it hurt. That one stung him. Two-punch combination scored clean. Ryan's now driving inside. Lemaire tried to turn to that patented guillotine, couldn't quite wrap it up.
Yeah, you got to be careful. Lemaire is moving a lot in front of Morgan, and his hands are dropping. And someone, you know, with that rhythm, you can exploit that rhythm when you see somebody that's continually doing that. And that's exactly what Morgan did when he saw the hands of Lemaire drop, and he exploited that.
Lemaire landing a couple knees inside there.
Now, to be honest, this is only helping Terry, really. I mean, if I was
Terry. He's going to that guillotine.
Oh, that's tight. He's got the angle.
Looking
that's
for
really
four.
Tight.
Trying to squeeze.
Now, Morgan's got the arm in, but Terry's squeezing.
He's only got half guard right. Well, he's got kind of
he's
three
got that
quarter there. Yeah.
Yeah, that's not bad because Terry's able to keep his angle, which he needs for that elbow to stay down. But Morgan did a good job pushing on it.
Ryan pops his head out, stays alive there.
Weathered the storm, didn't overreact. Good job by Morgan. Good composure.
Very
and
nice.
Now Terry's on the bottom. We'll see if he's able to use that to his advantage, either get up or throw up a submission here. Lots of time left in this round as well.
Yeah, trying to potentially secure an armbar, wasn't there. Scrambling, couple big shots here from top position. Forearm across the face, now putting the knee on the face.
Good job securing that position. Heavy shots, those elbows landing right on the ear of Terry Lemaire. Good job by Morgan Rhines.
Nice rally here from Rhines after finding himself in some difficult position earlier. Back to the feet they go. 45 seconds remaining here in round number one. Shot here late. Rhines with a nice sprawl against the cage.
Ooh,
real careful with positioning there.
Did a good job, and you've seen Terry react right away. Oh, nice little inside.
Oh, he jumps to the guillotine again. Can he get it this time?
This one actually looks a little tighter.
This is quite
a bit tighter. Morgan is starting to feel it.
To the side there. Final
he's
second.
Trying
ticking
to,
off the clock.
Oh,
here.
That is tight, but he's only got one arm. I think he's only got.
Oh, ooh. And he survives to the bell. Wow.
That was tight. That was tight.
Two really good guillotine chokes there from Terry Lemaire in round number one, and that was fun.
And Morgan was doing all the right things to try to escape there, so good to see he wasn't freaking out. But good job by Terry Lemaire. Obviously, we see what he's hunting.
Yeah, no accident that he's got those three guillotines, clearly. Dangerous with those as we take a look into the corner. A couple of deep breaths. take a look at some of that action. We had a couple big shots on the feed there, but those guillotine chokes were close on two occasions. This is the one that we thought he might have.
Yeah, that was a tight choke. Saved by the clock a little bit, maybe. We'll see. Both guys expended a lot of energy there, so we'll see who can recover the best here in this little break as we start the second round.
Competitive round number one here, our co-main event, Fight League Atlantic 8. It's been a night full of action so far. Our featured athletes looking to close it out with a bang. Morgan Rhines in the black, taking the center of the cage.
And I think the pace of the fight is what's going to dictate a lot. I mean, Morgan being a striker maybe isn't used to that type of pace, and Terry clearly loves that.
Now he's on the back.
Pushing the pace, I think, is going to be definitely to Terry's advantage. He's got the back now. He's got both hooks, but only one arm linked up there.
Trying to sink it under. He's got the right arm. Now he might
squeeze
on the neck.
Morgan going belly down. This is not a good position for Morgan.
Bad spot for Morgan Rhines.
This is not good. This is not good for Morgan. He's fighting the hands. He's got to get from his belly to his back. Good job there by Morgan. Great job. Wow.
Gutsy work there.
Good job for Morgan Rhines, fighting out of multiple submissions at this point.
Incredible work there. I thought he was done. Somehow stayed alive and is now in top position.
See if Morgan can use this position now to inflict some damage and try to win this round from position here. Drop some elbows.
A lot of time left after a very difficult start.
Terry doing a good job slowing the fight down, grabbing some arms here. And Morgan's dropping big elbows. Good job.
Nice heavy base there on top. And what do you know? Bear tries to secure the neck there. Not there this time. Clearly we know what he likes in these exchanges.
It'd be good for Terry to kind of get his back against the cage here and start to work to get to his feet.
Yeah, he's got that sweep. I agree, he's got that closed guard right now. Like to see him maybe open it up, see what options are available to him. Now he does. Left foot on the hip. Couple short punches in there, of course, his head trapped up against the fence.
It's really difficult when a guy's on top and he doesn't want you to move and he doesn't want to be super active from top. It's not to say Morgan's not being active. He is. He's dropped some heavy shots, but looking to pass there, good job. But sometimes it's just easy. A guy on top can keep your hips and jam you up against there, just like Morgan is right now.
Exactly. Just staying heavy on him, making it difficult.
Terry got a little deep half guard there, looking for the sweep to come out the back door. Looks like he may be successful. Good job.
Nice.
I think he's going to wrap that neck up again.
Shocker. Nice switches to the back once again. Beautiful work from Lamerida once again.
That's a lot of time there to be on the back of Morgan Rhines.
Hooks in place, feet are crossed, but Ryan's more worried about the hands right now. Ryan's throwing a couple punches back there as you see Lemaire just trying to get that right arm under the neck. Lemaire doing a good job of attacking while Ryan's doing a good job of controlling that choke arm, making it difficult.
Don't turn over.
Lemaire with short left hands, try to soften things up, see if he can get his opponent to adjust his grip a little bit.
Yeah, that kind of modified body lock there is really tough to deal with. Morgan almost rolled to his belly there. You can hear his corner yelling him not to turn to his belly. That's a horrible position to be.
Left arm comes around the neck.
Oh, and he's kind of jammed up there on the fence. Morgan's got to really fight the hands here if he can. Terry doing a really good job trying to sink that underneath the chin.
Just squeezing on the chin, just cranking on it right now. Not a choke, but not comfortable.
Pressure is there.
Absolutely.
And the cage is actually working to Terry's advantage there, I think, hiding his hands.
Switches hands to the other side.
Good job.
Rhines deals with it well. Those were some tense moments right there. Kind of went gable grip there briefly, then changed hands. Nice work for Lemaire from the back.
40 seconds.
The non-stop action between these two athletes.
Yeah, Morgan can isolate these hands and then maybe try to start to work on getting that body lock, flip to the outside, maybe slip his leg onto the inside, try to fight that lock, but he's in a really tough position there. Probably just ride out the clock and reset for round three.
Yeah, you see the clapper coming in here to indicate the final 10 seconds. There it is. And yeah, if you're Rhines, maybe a little bit of a moral victory just that you got out of those positions. Frustrating, I'm sure, but try to take some pauses out of it and know that, hey, at least I didn't get finished.
Yeah, and I mean, it's a learning experience, I guess, for Morgan, too, because he was comfortable in those situations when he was on top, when really maybe he could have tried to disengage and get the game back to where he was having the most success, which was in the striking.
You take a look at the replays here, and I mean, I thought he was done in that particular moment. Here was another good series. Just excellent work for Lemaire. We said it. Rhines recently got his purple belt, you know, trying to tighten things up in the grabbing department. I think the improvement is showing here, at least in terms of defense.
Yes, most definitely. I agree. Able to inflict a little bit of damage there on top, too.
Nice work there as we take a look into the corner. Lemaire also, I'm sure, happy with where he's been. Maybe a little bit frustrated that he hasn't finished the fight yet. I thought he had it done. He probably thought he had it done, too.
Yeah, a lot of good attempts from Terry Lemaire. I mean, he's just trying to have a good time.
That's it. They call him good time for a reason. Third and final round. Lemaire has been incredible with his grappling. Rhines has shown improved defense. But what does Rhines have in the tank here in round number three? Can he get something done on the feet? A little show of respect between the two. Spin kick there.
Nice takedown here.
Look at that.
Got inside. Jump the back. Well done.
Wow. Beautiful work from Lemaire. Realize that this is the best place for him to be. Even if for some reason he can't get the finish. I mean, dominating in his positioning here. Keeping himself safe from the striking.
The boys having a little talk here with each other.
Chatting a little bit. Sure, Ryan says, come on, why don't you let go? Let's go fight a little bit. He's looking up at the referee as well, saying, hey, this is a stall. But, boy, it's really hard as a referee to restart a fight from this position. Yeah. I don't care if they don't move at all. Really hard to break up when somebody's on the back.
Yeah, and you see this at the highest level, guys, that will ride this back position for the whole round. You can't stop this. It's your job to get out of that position, unfortunately.
Yeah.
He earned it, and he's there, right?
I agree. You hear the crowd booing, and I understand why, because they see it as a bit of a stall, but I just tend to agree with the referee here. Like, the man is on your back. You got to get out of here. And you can see Lemaire trying to threaten with that right arm, trying to sneak it up a little bit.
And it's a better position for Morgan to be standing. I mean, it's a better opportunity that he's going to burn his legs, but if you're Terry Lemaire, it's the third round. You're going to ride this out to the bitter end because this is what you got to win the fight. I mean, he did a good job weathering the storm in the first round, but the fight's kind of played out like you and I talked about previously, where Terry weathered that storm of the stand-up of Morgan, and then he turned it on with what was his A game.
Rhines again kind of looked up to the referee and just said, come on, man, shrugged. The referee kind of looked back at him and said, sorry, yeah. He's on your back. You got to get out of here.
I mean, if you're Morgan, you could shake him a little bit. You could kind of do some stuff here, use the cage a little bit to your advantage, try to peel him off. I mean, I know it's difficult with that body triangle, but you're down. You've got 3 minutes left in the fight, and the guy's a backpack on you. And I don't think that he's showing any signs of giving up the position, so.
And I'll tell you what, Rhines has got to be careful with the kind of shrugging move to the referee, because when he does that, he's not thinking about defense, and there the position breaks. And I understand Rhines' frustration there, I really do. But, I mean, that's just the reality when you're on the back.
Yeah.
Lemaire just relentless with his takedowns here.
Yeah, he can taste victory, and after that long layoff, he's looking to get back in that win column, I'm sure. And he's put it on Morgan here in these scrambles, these positions.
Slipping to the back there. Rhines briefly had control of the head, but had to let that go. Lemaire on the back once again.
And as you mentioned, I mean, Morgan's showing a lot of improvements with his defense and his advancement in the ground skills. But, you know, next is, you know, not allowing these positions to happen, I guess. Easier said than done, I understand, but...
But you're right. It's the progression that you're trying to make.
Exactly.
Okay, great. You can survive here. Now do you make sure you just don't get here?
Yeah, and it's their small micro movements sometimes, and you make the movement before you even realize, then it's too late, right? And you're kicking yourself in the butt for it. But
well, time running out here for Morgan Rhines. Minute 20 remaining. Terry Lemaire comfortably on the back. He's got that figure four around the body. He's continuing to kind of at least tease the choke enough that Rhines certainly has to respect it.
Yeah, I mean, he's not looking to just ride out the clock. He is still looking to finish it. Morgan's doing a good job defending and controlling the hands, but, you know, Terry is still looking for the opportunity to finish this fight. Make no qualms about it.
You're punctuating the punches there. Verbally, Rhines was kind of having a little conversation in there as well. I think he's frustrated. Lemaire continuing to hunt here. They're going to exchange punches. But Rhines just not able to get out of this back control position.
I mean, showing frustration. I mean, you're frustrated, but showing it that way is sometimes it's put your energy into trying to get out. Maybe.
Completely agree.
Terry's looking to sync that up.
I like it. Push it to the very end. You hear the clapper there. Final 10 seconds. You can't criticize Lemaire for not trying to get this done. And I like it.
He's trying.
I love it. Trying to make something happen. That was something that maybe could have done earlier. I think referee is going to make sure there's no, yeah. I think there was a little frustration. Lemaire just kind of gives a little shrug. Didn't get the finish, but a big win after some time away and after a difficult loss last time out. And again, you know, Rhines showed some improvement here. I think he can take some pride in some of this.
Yeah, I mean, he's visibly frustrated, obviously.
Understandably.
That's half the game right there. It's not a kickboxing match, unfortunately. You do have to worry about when someone gets your back.
Got to be able to work out his positions. A little dance there. All right, a little hip movement. He's feeling it.
But definitely Morgan showed a lot of signs of improvement in the ground game, trying to fight out of those chokes. It's just unfortunate when somebody has your body movements, they're just one step ahead of you in that position.
That's exactly what happened there. And again, I think for Morgan Rhines, as you see the frustration there, I do think he can take some positives out of this and feel better about his performance. I mean, it's going to be a loss, but, you know, I mean, it's about getting better all the time, and I think he is getting better.
And unfortunately for him, I think that's two in a row now.
Right.
Come on, Morgan. What's up, brother?
What's up?
Woo!
Got a shout out for John Morgan as well. Taking the advantage of his time in there. Nice work.
The good thing for Terry too is, you know, after the knockout that you mentioned,
Canada.
Being able to
guy right here.
Weather the storm that Morgan brought to him, tagged him a few times, and he was able to know that he can trust his chin again.
Absolutely. And that's key in itself, too. That's a great point as well. Didn't know if it was going to hold up. It did. That's big for him.
And I mean, the fight, there was a lot that happened in that fight, despite the fact that that whole round was what it was. I mean, those first two rounds were pretty dynamic, so the fans should... have very short memories, I guess.
We'll see. Scores have been tabulated. Craig Ferguson is in the cage.
All right, fight fans, here is the judge's decision. Judge LeBlanc scores it 29-28, Lemaire. Judge Poirier scores it 29-28, Rhines. Judge Gallant scores it 29-28 for the winner by split decision. In the red corner from Timmins, Ontario, Terry Lemaire.
That was me, not all me.
there. You seemed very confident you were going to get that decision. Make your case here for the people.
Hey, you know what, man? I'm in his backyard. It's his hometown. You got some fans here, Morgan Rhines. You guys are awesome. And you know what? I'm here on the East Coast, out of my hometown. I expect that from the judges. I should have got the finish.
Terry, you came out in the second round. It seemed like something changed mentally, like you knew that you could get to his back whenever you wanted. Tell me what changed. What do your corners say to you between rounds?
Well, you know what? My trainer's a very persistent fella. And that was the game plan. It was Kier to come wrestle him. But you know what? I wanted to strike. You know, I told him I'd give him some striking. So I gave him the first round of striking because I know my elite kickboxing skills match up to his just as good as his. So yeah, we went back to the game plan in the second and the third, and we pulled out with the victory.
Well, you're taking the win back to Timmins, Ontario. Will you come back here to Halifax or to the Maritimes and fight League Atlantic again? Will we see Terry Lemaire again?
You know what, man? You put something that's worth it in front of me. This is a great promotion. I've been talking with Derek and John for a while, pre-COVID. You guys have a great production here, great crew. I love the fans. You guys are awesome. I think it's time we put some gold around my waist while I go to Sean Shelby and Dana White and we bring me on that Toronto card in the summer.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner by split decision, Terry Lemaire.